Ladies and gentlemen, it's Niall, it's Louis, it's Zayn, it's Harry, it's Wonder.
Hello! So good.
Have you eaten the other member?
Yes.
Where is he?
He's ill.
He ate one of us, and now he's ill.
Oh. You can't.
He's
really
called in sick.
Has he really?
Yeah.
Has he got the lurgy?
Well, supposedly, yeah.
What happens if one of you gets
too many girls?
If one, well, let's talk more about that. If one of you gets the lurgy, are they put in isolation so they don't infect the rest of the band?
Yeah.
Is that because you
can't?
Like swine flu. Just get cast off. Just get sent off.
You get put into a quarantine.
Well, listen, it's nice to have you guys back at Key 103.
Thanks for having us back.
Listen, it's a pleasure to have you back. I'm going to put it out there. I don't think I've said this to anyone before. You don't even need us anymore.
You don't need to come back
to Q103. You've now become the most successful band in the world, and here you are.
No,
love Q103.
You do love Q103, Harry. Yeah. Your station. Now, before we begin the interview proper, are there any questions we're banned from asking? Are there anything we can't talk about today?
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Come on then,
Mike.
Yeah. Come on then, Mike. You've changed. Yeah, go.
You did release a statement about this. You mean business, don't you? One Direction have released a statement.
But it's just, it was just a bit unfair, to be honest, the way that was taken. We just want to keep it fresh and interesting for the fans, and that's the most important thing. And we had feedback from the fans, and people were just saying, we've heard who your celebrity crush is, so...
Stop asking the same questions.
Yeah. That's
our first question. Should have read the statement.
Well, we never ask you the same questions. We always ask you the questions you never actually ever really want to answer. Listen, here's a good question. I wrote this myself this morning for you guys. Was there, because obviously, I mean, you've had a fairly successful couple of years. Has there been one defining moment where you kind of looked at each other and you thought, bloody hell, life is never going to be the same? What was that? What was that one?
I think VMAs, because
it was a big one,
exact moment for me was when they called on him for the first one.
Yeah, they were like, it just seemed so ridiculous because when we found out we were going, we were like really buzzed to be going. We were like, oh my god, we're going to VMAs. And then obviously found out we were performing, which was amazing. And then to win was just...
Yeah.
What about being on the back of a truck at the Olympics? That must have been fairly up there.
Well, yeah.
You know, I was a bit worried for your safety, in fact.
Those two, I think, are the two where we really came off stage and were like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Actually, do you remember when we were doing one of the rehearsals for the Olympics that... It was actually quite dangerous. Remember the guy once slammed his brakes on
him? Oh, yeah, we nearly flew off.
Yeah, if he was a wanted fan, he could have really took you out.
Yeah, he would have.
Well, I always think you're not famous until my mum's heard of you. And my mum has indeed heard of you.
That is great.
Yes. Yeah. Olga Tulin is a fan.
Olga I like Olga.
Olga is a fan.
You do, Harry.
Harry, that's my mother. You stay away from her. We know what you're like. Listen, guys, it's been the most amazing sort of uptime. In fact, there doesn't really appear to be, and I don't want to dwell on any negative, there doesn't really appear to be any downs for you guys in the last couple of years. Pretty much every story, it's just built... It's just building and building, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is so far so good. Have any of you ever been ribbed by the rest of the band as of having had a diva strop? Have you ever turned around and go, come on, Zayn, don't get wrapped up in it?
Has anyone smashed a telly?
Has anyone said, I demand first class?
Not on purpose.
Really?
Yeah. Not in like a rock and roll way. It'll be like one of us have fallen into it. And be
right,
like,
okay.
Oh, God.
We kind of have those, like, if we're ever going to have, like, crazy moments, it's like crazy for fun, not crazy for diva. Like,
yeah,
like, we've had, like, fruit fights and stuff like that in the hotel room and trust them and been told off a little bit. But
right.
No, like...
Fruit fights. I like that. So
that's
you've been
how rock and roll we are. We
launching satsumas at each other.
Healthy stuff.
Yeah. Okay.
Which actually, when they, like, if they splat on a wall, they actually make the room smell really nice.
Yeah.
It smells of orange.
Is that your excuse?
We're doing the hotel a favour.
Yeah, absolutely.
Never mind potpourri. This is the real deal. what about the... Has there been one thing you've kind of... You could isolate each of... Has any of you wasted money on anything? Because obviously now money is a different thing. Have you ever blown a certain... Harry, you're giving me a glint in the eye there. What have you wasted money on? Harry, you've got a big thing about cars going on, haven't you?
I do like them, yeah. I'd say investments.
Houses are investments. Cars are not investments.
If they're collectibles, they are.
How many cars have you got? Come on.
I have two.
And what kind are they? You don't have to give us the registration numbers.
One of them's a classic car. Which is
Is it an Aston Martin?
No, it's an E-Type Jag. Oh.
Will you take me for a spin?
If you want.
I've never even been in an E-Type Jag.
Okay.
What about Louis? Have you ever wasted any money on anything?
Yeah, I'm terrible with money.
Are you?
I really am.
I'm really good with it. Do you want me to look after it?
Yeah please. Okay. Just...
She's like Martin Lewis.
I am, moneysavingexpert.com.
I'm not very good at saving money. I'm getting better, but...
When you get large amounts of money in, do you have these kind of sort of lecherous accountant-type people who say, right, listen, let me look after that. I'm going to invest that in offshores.
Not really.
Do you have all those people advising you?
Okay, so ours is Irish. He's kind of like, no, come on now, lads, you got to be more sensible with this.
It's
not
me, Louis.
Yeah, I was going to go, take it to deadlock.
He just goes, this is like how the conversation usually goes. Louis, man, you can't be doing this. You can't be doing this all the time. I'm spending all my savings.
That's exactly it.
So the album, Take Me Home. Yeah, when is the album out?
The album is out 12th of November.
Neglect. 12th of November.
Yeah.
Neglect.
And is it the difficult second album? Was it difficult to put together?
I think at the start we were really nervous because we didn't have much time to record it at all. And we were just kind of nervous because, you know, second album's the one that everyone had said, this is the hardest one.
Yeah.
And then when it came down to it, I think we'd figured our sound through the first album. So we really knew what the kind of One Direction sound is now. So, you know, we could really focus on that and just make sure that we got the best songs that we could get. And we think this album's kind of on another level to the last one.
Is it better than the previous one, yeah?
Not that the last one's bad.
Because I thought the last one was so-so, to be honest. No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm joking.
See you later.
Okay, and that's out on the 12th of November. Yes. And Live While We're Young, of course, is out now. Yeah. We played that whenever it was, about a month ago on the show, whenever it was. And was it the next day it had gone to number one on the downloads in something absurd like 40 countries? That just colossal. Does that still surprise you, that level of success? Or is it... Are you kind of almost used to it now?
No, they look at the watch and go, 3 minutes, number one now.
Right? 3 minutes, yeah. We're number one in Sweden.
it's crazy, you know. It's not something, you know, that you can kind of get used to. I think it is what it is, and you just, like, we just try to take it in our stride and not take anything too seriously and just keep having fun with what we're doing. But obviously, when we hear them sort of statistics, we're just blown away and, like, just really thankful that people go out and buy our music and they're really supportive and dedicated.
The video looked so much fun. I actually I got home yesterday and Matt had left the music channel on, and your video was the first one that came on. And it's the first time I've probably like sat and watched it properly. And I was trying to figure out like what was sort of staged and what wasn't. You just genuinely look like you are throwing each other about, bombing it in a jeep.
None of it was staged at all.
There was no script. We just got there and we had different scenarios, like when we're in those big inflatable balls and stuff.
Yeah.
And he just said, right, do what you want.
Yourself.
And that's why it was just amazing. It was like really fun.
There's
like
a really quick bit, actually, of Zayn. Your hair, like, blowing in the wind all down over your face.
Yeah, that shot, I actually had a camera.
Oh,
and,
under
like,
your chin.
I was filming it while we were, like, going over the bumps.
Oh, so
that,
yeah.
That's why I think it's... Footage. That's why I like the video, because it's not really that flattering of us, you know? There's shots of us, like, especially that, like, our hair. It's like, crazy. But
by the end...
Yeah.
Your hair, I mean, talking of your hair now, your hair pretty much, it looks like you're permanently, you know,
just take them off at night.
It's like Lego.
It's a
Lego
wig, heads. Isn't it, Harry? There is the guy in Union J. Obviously, we saw you on X Factor a couple of weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And that was a kind of a weird thing even as a viewer to watch, because it looked like, hang on, One Direction meet Little One Direction. But
they're older than us, is the weirdest thing.
One of them's 24.
One of them's 24.
I can't remember his name.
The youngest guy's 19.
Is he? There's one area who looks just like you.
George.
Is it? George Shelley.
George Sampson's joined.
George Sampson's about 19 as well.
We edit that bit out.
He's doing Singing in the Rain.
Have you been dishing out style advice to him, Harry?
No, it wasn't style advice. He just told me that people kept telling him to cut his hair.
Yeah.
And I just said, don't.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't bother.
Right, okay.
Do whatever you want.
Yeah. And what did you talk to these guys about? What did they ask you backstage?
I don't know.
It was just like, do you have any advice for us? And
Yeah.
Feels weird giving advice, though.
We don't even feel like experts ourselves.
Do you not? Oh, that's nice, Zayn.
Yeah, so it's strange to kind of think that somebody's looking to us for advice.
Why
yeah.
did you come on the X Factor, like, in this big...
It was a shameless...
And then all of a sudden, and then go off 30 seconds
It was a
later.
Shameless plug of our single.
Oh, right.
You didn't even say anything, Harry. You didn't even get a chance to speak. It was Niall. He got Dermot's question wrong. He was booted off.
Couldn't hear him.
Oh, why? Did you answer wrong to the question?
I couldn't hear him.
Sure, Dermot, I can't hear you.
Well, so you just make up any answer?
Yeah. Sounds about right.
Yeah, the family are good.
Yeah. So I just went for it.
Yeah.
Sure, I heard 2 years ago.
Well, yeah. The X Factor.
I presume you're going to be back performing on it at some point in this series, though.
TBC.
We're waiting for the invite.
TBC.
TBC.
Oh, okay. Oh, right. Okay.
And Niall, there was something I read recently about you and Talisa dressing up. Is that true? I'm not talking in each other's clothes.
Or...
You were in high heels and a lovely spandex number.
We just have V Festival and we trade the disguise each other.
All right, and that was pretty much
of
it.
Of course you did.
Yeah. Do you ever
disguise me?
If you were going out and you didn't want to be recognised, would you ever? I mean, obviously, so you did at the V Festival, Niall. Let me ask Louis. Would you ever disguise yourself? I mean, what is the standard?
You'd look brilliant in a pair of those glasses with a nose and a moustache.
Well, to be honest, we did for our tour videos, and there was a picture that came out of me. I was in like this fat suit, and like they had like all the.
Prosthetics.
Yeah, like that's the word. Yeah, with I had massive cheeks and you couldn't tell it was me. That was quite good fun.
That was so funny.
Really stupid.
I was an old lady.
This is in some video or this is just...
Our tour screens.
Harry, there's so many jokes when you said old lady. There's a lot of gags I could make there, but I'm not going to.
Yeah. No innuendos, please, Mike.
He's looking at me in a really bad way.
Not be coming back.
Oh, no, don't ever say that. So, guys, just very quickly then, I know you've got to go in a minute. The next few weeks, obviously, you promote the album. Are you all over the world or are you based in the UK? What's happening for the next few weeks?
Yeah, we're kind of...
We're everywhere next year.
Everywhere.
Doing different bits and pieces around Europe for a while.
Yeah,
we're doing 4 or 5 Yeah, we
start the world tour on February 22nd in London.
Yeah.
I've answered it wrong. Yeah, and then we're on the road for about 8 months of next year.
You know
when
you don't hear the question, you answer it.
Yeah. 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 I got to be in the X Factor, so ha, you got wrong.
What did he answer wrong? I thought he answered that right, didn't he?
No, I thought you answered the single.
Yeah.
No, that's what we're up to.
He talked about the world tour.
About the world tour. So you spend
quite finished.
So you've got 8 months, and that must be difficult then, being away from your family and friends when you're there. Obviously, it's exciting, and you are quite literally living the dream. But is there a bit of you're like, oh God, when am I going to see my girlfriend? When am I going to see my mum again?
I think that's probably the only it's probably the only con of what we do. Mm. Like
Acon,
yeah.
Said it wrong.
Just like we're not being able to see our friends and family as much, but you know,
we're out traveling the world. You can say they're coming with me.
Yeah, like, we do. Sometimes they do come out, but obviously, like. You know, especially that family, like subject to work and that kind of thing.
I suppose then the pressure's on you because you're trying to work, but you also want to spend time with them.
Yeah,
and make
you
sure
do
they're
get
okay,
that.
So
exactly,
it gets
it's actually dead stressful if you're like your family or girlfriend's over because you have to like make sure everything's
they're
over
okay.
there.
Because Louis, you're going out with a girl. We won't say what her name is. But you're going out with a girl. She's at Manchester.
Everyone knows, yeah.
Eleanor.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So you're going out with a girl. She's here
goes
in Manchester.
To uni in Manchester. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, wow, cool. Are you getting a chance to see her today or?
Yeah, I saw her last night and she's coming down later on. I think.
Manchester.
That's
cool. Manchester. And can we just else very quickly before we go because all the girls want to know who else is loved up here and who isn't. Niall, Zayn, of course you're with Perry, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
And okay, and things are going amazingly well for Little Mix, aren't they?
Yeah, they're doing really well. Yeah,
smashing it, aren't they?
DNA.
Really good.
Really happy for
they it. Are. They
what do you think about the Girls Aloud reunion, by the way?
Sick. Wicked. I went to watch Cheryl the other night at the O2 in London.
That is so Niall, isn't it?
Yeah. Goes to every
so support for my. Fellow
X Factor people. Yeah.
Nothing to do with the fact that her boobs nearly fall out of that
no,
car.
I
jumpsuit.
Saw those pictures.
Yeah.
They were
right. I did.
That was a proper wardrobe.
She looked incredible. And she dances very well too.
Yeah, she does. Did you listen to any of her songs? I thought you were asking a question.
Sorry,
Moisa. He asked, do you listen to the song? You're a fan of Cheryl's music?
I really
that. I really like it.
You know that...
Flood.
Don't say my name song. No, call my name.
How do you think it feels?
Yeah,
call
I really like that song.
Yeah. Okay.
That's a lyric
that you think. Fellas, listen, you've got to go. And thank you again for... Niall, what are you doing?
I'm doing some Next Level Dancing.
Thank you very much
thank
for popping in again.
Much.
Seriously.
Thank you for having
us. And this has been One Ruddy Direction on King
Ruddy Direction!
Ruddy Direction!
Ruddy!